Would that be more important than my rights or poetic rights that I have, those rights?
You seem to always have rights. I'm going to sleep. So the movers are coming in the morning, so just finish packing the boxes. I'll get up early, we'll finish, I'll make them sandwiches, we'll feed them lunch. But we have to get it all done tomorrow because we only have one day with them and that's it. And we have to pay by the box and by the hour. So we have to get it all done tomorrow. Wait till tomorrow, leave me alone.
I love you.
Whatever.
Yeah. When I read you poems about the glass man fell today, remember the shattered glass? I read you poems about the shattered glass and the glass man fell today. Remember the Talk magazine lady recorded it?
Whatever.
And I was in the streets. I was on the streets. Okay. All right.
There
so I'm looking for
it.
Okay. So the Talk magazine lady. Yeah. The Talk magazine lady recorded it. This is going past 8:28. And then I go into 9. Okay. 9:01. There's 9:07. Please remember, as I'm dead when I write this, my heart beats while I print the words with my pen. But in truth, I died years ago. I hope you learned from my pen or my death. I hope it is all well spent. Actually, I wrote that. Okay, so here is 9/11, fear in New York. So then I go to the glass man fell today. The glass crackled, smoke arises, sirens cry. Anger ties us. We will look down again. We will win, but still the sun shines on my face and surprises. I think of humans, Egyptians, pyramids, a race of builders tested. I think of glass and time and war needs resting and how it rises to sublime. But what must come up and stretch to a sky, and stretch to a sky must fall down and dreadfully die. And I'm not happy. I cost her a friend. A glass man fell today, but it's not the end. So, okay. So that can be added. If it's like space and time linked to 9/11, would that be more important than my rights or poetic rights that I have? I have those rights. You know, I have those rights.
You seem to always have rights. I'm going to sleep. Look, the movers are coming in the morning, so just finish packing and I'll sort it out in the morning. I'll get up early. I'll make them lunch. We'll feed them. They'll get it all sorted out. And we'll just shut up and finish packing. We'll take care of it in the morning.
But I think it's cute. You always said what? It was probably the first time I met you. It was when it was probably breaking into Johnny's door with a tire iron.
What?
Johnny, the drunk, he left keys in his apartment. We broke in, and you thought we were crooks, and I said hello, and you said what to me? It's in our Bible, in the intro page, in the marital page, how we met. You approached wide-eyed with your what's. I'm writing about this. I want them to know. Everyone should know.
You can't do that.
I have rights. They're poetic. And you met me, and I read poems about 9/11 to you. And you liked them. I read them, and you liked them. And I was too, what was it? Was I too close to the buildings falling? The man on the payphone yelling King Kong? Like a coward running from the clouds, the threats, the nuclear suitcase? Remember, hiding in the basement?
You can't use me in your story. I will put it in my will, and I will take it away from you. I have rights.
You know, the first time we got past what? I read you poems about the shattered glass and the glass man fell today, remember? And the Talk magazine lady recorded it?
Whatever.
I was on the streets past church. What if it's about, like, space and time linked to 9/11? Would that be more important than my rights? Or rights? Or poetic rights? I have those rights.
I have rights, too.